Our next speaker is from Gothenburg in Sweden. Her name is Netha Hussain. She's a medical doctor and researcher. She's been active in Wikipedia for more than 10 years, but she also writes articles around medicine and healthcare. But in real life, I think you're a physician and a researcher, and your research is around virtual reality and the assessment of post-stroke impairment. Is that right? I think that's what your Wikipedia page says anyway. So in recent months, your focus of your writing has inevitably been on COVID-19, and you're going to be talking to us about the role that why Wikipedia matters in the current pandemic. So,
Thank you very much for the introduction. So I will be talking about why Wikipedia matters during the COVID-19 pandemic. So Wikipedia is the world's largest encyclopedia. The goal of Wikipedia is to become the essential infrastructure in the ecosystem of free knowledge. Wikipedia has always responded to crises happening around the world by sharing free knowledge. This has been made possible by dedicated volunteers who work tirelessly for adding and updating content on Wikipedia. So here is how Wikipedia is responding to the COVID-19 crisis. It was on 31st December 2019 that suspicions about a cluster of previously unknown pneumonia cases were reported from China. Just 5 days after the disease was detected, the English Wikipedia article about COVID-19 first appeared. Since then, the article has undergone major expansion, and now it gives a comprehensive overview of the COVID-19 pandemic. The article has been edited by over 2,800 editors, including people like me, other medical doctors, and researchers. The article about the COVID-19 pandemic on the English language Wikipedia has now been viewed over 50 million times. And the same article is now present in 131 language editions of Wikipedia. So now you can read about the COVID-19 pandemic in Russian, Malayalam, Swedish, Telugu, or several other languages of the world. Wikipedia matters during the COVID-19 pandemic because it has a wealth of information, it gathers a huge viewership, and because it has many language editions. And therefore, it becomes important that updated and reliable information appears on Wikipedia. One of the main problems that many countries are facing today is misinformation. Misinformation has become so rampant in the context of COVID-19 that the World Health Organization called it an infodemic. Misinformation could be in the form of conspiracy theories, fake drugs, or even prevention methods that don't really work. So there is a Wikipedia article that lists all the fake medicines against COVID-19. There is a longer Wikipedia article for listing all kinds of misinformation related to COVID-19. Wikipedia even has an article about xenophobia and racism in the context of the COVID-19 pandemic. Wikipedia has articles about overarching topics such as human rights issues during the COVID-19 pandemic, and also about very specific topics such as impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on abortion in the United States. So there is a Wikipedia article about the COVID-19 pandemic situation for every country in the world, including Antarctica. And by now, there are over 2,500 articles on Wikipedia surrounding the theme of COVID-19. Wikipedia matters now more than ever due to the changing nature of information surrounding the pandemic. Traditional encyclopedias are not able to collect, curate, analyze, and present data in such a fast pace as Wikipedia does. So more and more people are turning to Wikipedia for gathering new information related to COVID-19. And therefore, it becomes very important that the articles on Wikipedia are updated and reliable. If you ask Amazon's Alexa or Apple's Siri about COVID-19, they give you information by looking up Wikipedia. So it's time that we realize the importance of sharing free knowledge and making sure that Wikipedia is reliable and updated. Thank you very much for this opportunity.